Ranger Lindsay. You ready to head down into the tide pools?
The tide pools? No, I can't go down there.
What? Why not?
I mean, it's dangerous. There's predators, there's sneaker waves. I can't go down there without some kind of protection.
Oh, well, if it's protection you're looking for, I think I know just the thing to help.
The Sea Urchin's Guide to Protection in the Tide Pools.
Yep, Sea urchins are all about protection, which is why we devised this handy guidebook to help understand exactly how they're able to stay safe in their environment. In fact, sea urchins have a strategy to protect themselves from just about any type of threat you might experience in the tide pools.
Anything? Even predators?
Even predators. This guidebook boils down those protective strategies into three easy-to-follow categories.
Well, if that's true, then that's amazing.
Well, let's take a look.
1. Protection from predators. Strategy, spines. Sea urchins belong to the phylum Echinoderm, literally meaning spiny skin. So it's no wonder that their round shells are covered in long, hard spines. Each spine is made of a hard material called calcium carbonate, which makes up the protective shells of most marine invertebrates in the ocean. Sea urchins use these spines as their main defense against predators like sea otters, sunflower stars, and seagulls, making them immensely difficult to eat. A predator is going to think twice before swallowing a sea urchin whole, since it doesn't feel very good to get those spines stuck in their throat. But don't let that deter you. It's safe to touch a purple sea urchin as long as you do it gently. And remember, those spines are sharp, so don't step on them. With protection from predators taken care of, sea urchins can shift their attention to another common threat prevalent in the tide pools, excessive sunlight. 2. Protection from the sun. Strategy, shells, rocks, and other marine debris. The intertidal zone is a harsh place to live, with the tide receding twice a day and leaving animals exposed to the sun for long periods of time. As such, many tide pool animals have developed special adaptations to prevent themselves from drying out or overheating. Whereas some animals have shells that close tightly to hold in moisture, urchins have a different strategy to protect themselves from the sun. Using hundreds of tiny tentacles called tube feet, urchins grab hold of bits of shells, stones, and algae they find in the water column and cover their bodies with them. These tube feet hold these rocks and shells in place, which in turn provide not only an added layer of protection from predators, but also shade, effectively shielding the urchin from UV rays. It's almost like urchins are wearing tiny hats all over their bodies. As the tide comes back in, an urchin's exposure to sunlight diminishes, but they're not safe yet. A new threat has rolled in to put the urchin's protective skills once again to the test. Intense wave action. 3. Protection from waves. Strategy, burrows. Ocean waves can be incredibly strong, crashing against the rocks of the intertidal zone with enough force to do some serious damage to the animals that live there. If a wave successfully dislodges a tide pool animal from the rocks, that animal is likely to get washed ashore or even swept out to sea, where it will not survive. Sea urchins have devised a creative solution to protect themselves from this unfortunate fate. If you explore the tide pools, you'll often find sea urchins tucked into holes in the rocks. Amazingly, urchins dig these holes themselves, literally chewing into the hard rock using 5 razor-sharp teeth located on the underside of their bodies. These teeth are self-sharpening and continuously regrow as they wear away at the rocks, meaning they're always in tip-top shape for the urchin's next rocky bite. These self-made burrows are the urchin's clever way of protecting themselves from crashing waves, as they provide shelter from the worst of the ocean's powerful surf and ensure that the urchin is unlikely to get knocked off the rocks. When it's time to eat, urchins will leave the shelter of their burrows in search of some tasty kelp. But they never worry about getting lost. After eating their fill, urchins have no problem returning to their individual homes, where they can snuggle in, safe and sound.
Wow, Ranger Lindsay, you are really taking this protection thing seriously.
Oh yeah, I think the urchins have the right idea. I feel so much safer.
Are those hats all over your body?
Yeah, I have very sensitive skin.
Okay, and what are those?
Oh, that's my burrow to protect me from sneaker waves. Don't worry, I got one for you too.